Welcome back in your ICT class. So today we are here with a very new topic of the same chapter, learning on MS Excel, creating a new worksheet. These all are the practical topic. If you want to create a new worksheet, so you can click on the file tab, click on new option, then click on blank workbook, then click on create option. Let's do it practically. How can we do? This is your desktop. If you want to open MS Excel, you go on the start button, all programs, MS Office, and then MS Excel. The MS Excel window will be open on your screen. If you want to create a new document, so you can go on your file tab, select the blank workbook and click on it. The new document will be appear. By default, your document name is book 1, book 2. Okay. If you save it, so it will be renamed. This is your title bar. This is your tabs. This part is called ribbon. And this is your name box. By default, my current working cell is A1. So A1 is present here. If I am clicking here, so F5 will be here. This is our formula bar. Whatever I have to enter here, it will be visible on the formula bar. Like I am entering here 23, okay, 25, like this. Whatever the content we have to enter, it will be visible on the formula bar. Let's move on another topic. Entering a data in a worksheet. If you want to enter any data in a worksheet, you have to click on the specific cell with where you want to enter a data, and then you can type a letter and press the enter key like this. Just let's see it practically how to do. Like this is your worksheet. If you want to enter data, place a cursor here. Here you can type it grade 6, or you can type it name. Name of the student, name of the student. Okay, and you can type it here roll number, SR number, serial number. Okay, and if you want to increase the size of this column, put your cursor here. Cursor will be changed into a plus symbol. You can drag the size of the specific cell. Okay, so you can enter like 1, 2. Okay, and you can enter a name like Raj. Arohi, etc. Like this, you can enter a new data in your worksheet. Let's move on another topic. Modify your data. If you want to modify your data, you can use three options like cut, copy, and paste. With the help of the cut, copy, paste, you can modify your data that you have entered in an Excel sheet. For the cut, copy, paste, you can use the option. These options are present in Home tab, and you can use the shortcut key. So, what is the shortcut key of cut? It control X. What is the shortcut key of the copy? Control C, and the paste. Move a copy a cell. If you want to move and copying a cell, so how to do? You select the cell which you want to move. Select the cell which you want to move, and then click on the Home tab cut option. Cut is used to move a specific cell, and copy is used to move a specific cell. Copy is used to make a duplicate copy of it. Like C, select the cell, click on the cut button, copy button, and the copied content will be highlighted. Click on the C where you want to paste, and click on the paste button. See, the Raj will be coming here also and here also. So copy is and paste is used to make a duplicate copy of an object, and cut and paste is used to move an object. Like see, if you want to move an Arohi from here to the next cell, so you can click on the cut option and you can paste it here. See, it is moved. Let's move on another topic. Column width and row height. If you want to change a column width and row height, so by default a worksheet, we can specify a column width 0 to 255 and row height we can specify 0 to 409. So what is a what the range we can give for the column width? For the column width we can give the range 0 to 255 and for the row height we can give 0 to 409. By default column width is 8.43. What is the default column width? 8.43 characters. Okay, what is the default height of the row? It is 15 points. Height always measured in points and width always measured in characters in worksheet. In a worksheet, okay. If the column and row width is zero, that means your row and column is hidden. It is not visible to anyone. Okay, let's see how to change the column and row width. Let's do it practically. If you want to set the column and row width, we have to select the column which we want to change, and we have to click on Home tab, Format command. Then we have to choose the drop down list. Then we choose the column height and the row height and the column width from the drop down list. The column width dialog box will be appear. Type the value which you want, and then click on OK. Let's do it practically. Like, see, this is your column. If I want to change the column width, so one option is we can drag it. If you don't want to drag it, so what we have to do, we have to change the column width like this. If it is same as the, see, I am doing a undo button, I am using a undo option. Okay, now if I want to change a column width, so go on the Home tab, Format tab. Here is a row height and column height. Okay, if I want to change the height, so we can click on the row height. See, by default 15 is written here. You can type it anything. You can type 30 over here and click on OK. The height is going to be, the current height is going to be increased. The height is increased. If you want to change the column widths, so you can go on the Format tab, column width. By default it is 8.43, so you can type it. You can type 40. See, the column width is increased now. So this is a procedure to increase and decrease the size of the column width. Automatically fit the contents. What is automatically fit the content? Click on the select all button. If you want to automatically fit the content, so click on the select all button and then double click on the boundary which you want to change, and then all the columns and row in the entire worksheet will be changed in a new worksheet. See how to do. This is your select all button. Select it, and what we have to do, double click on the boundary between two columns. Select all the rows and go on the Format tab, auto fit row height. When you click on the auto fit row height, so what will happen? Suppose we have entered name of the students, SR number. Okay, see, now my content is moving outside of the B column. So if I want to set my column width according to the content, so I go on the Format tab and auto fit height, and auto fit column width. See, the column width is going to be adjusted according to the content. So children, we will discuss till here only. Next topic we will discuss in our next class. God bless you all. Bye bye. Take care.